where money, little bits of money that is generated within funds should be spent in funds. For example, of the 548,000 of Section 106 money received for the King's Highway developments, 54k of money was earmarked for local community, for the local community, which should be spent for the public realm. Guess where it went? Cut East Ark Gardens.
No, it didn't.
It most certainly did. And 63,000 went for an open space. For open space went to a borehole in Wellford Pleasance, Eltham North. And monies remain unspent. For of the 353 collected after a planning application, I have the reference of the planning application, we will see it afterwards. 52k of education money went to providing SEN places at a school in Middle Park. 13k went to the same in Wickham Lane. And what the serious thing about that particular parcel of money, 265k of it remains unspent despite the application being from 2010. There's lots of that is, and not only should we know about that money, we should be being consulted about it. And we get and that also projects, pet projects like the Plumstead Library, which I've been here for 30 years, and it's a quart into a pint pot. It's 12 million, it's going to go up to 16 million, and it's going to go up and up and up. We weren't consulted, we're not getting value for money. It grieves me as an economist that we're, as a resident, we're not getting value for money. And if I get elected, one of the things I want to do is a 3-month pause and look at the books, and that's what I want to do.
Yes, well, with regards to how, you know, the kind of deal we are getting in Plumstead at the moment, I think we are getting a raw deal. I don't think, I think if we had a louder voice in Plumstead, I think we could do better. As I said, it's one thing to come here and tell you folks that we've spent X amount on this or X amount on that, but relatively speaking, is that really enough to make an impact? Because we don't have anything to compare it to. You know, we don't have an amount to know if that's actually a decent amount of money that is being mentioned, or is it just because it sounds big, we can all think that, oh, okay, they must have spent they're spending this amount on it. So I don't think that's good enough to just say we've spent X amount on this, that, or the other. I think we have to be able to analyze properly and understand, okay, is it really a good deal? Are we getting good value for money? I think we all pay our council taxes, and those of us who live in this ward, because I go around the borough, and I think to myself, so why is it so much different here? Why can't we have that here as well? Because, you know, we're all decent human beings. We want to enjoy the same benefits that everybody around the borough is enjoying. So if we are not benefiting from the way things are at the moment, I think we need people that will give us a louder voice in the borough and make sure that more funds come to where we are so that we can enjoy the benefits of living in this borough as well. And that's why I would like you to vote for me as councillor on the day. It's not only local, it's also an opportunity to send a message nationally as well. That's how the local elections are used. So I will ask you to vote for me on the day, and we will try and do our very best to represent instead the way we would like to be represented. Thank you.
Starting with that question quickly, there is a lot of money available in Greenwich, there is a lot of development going on, and it all doesn't need to stay in the area that it is. And most of the development's going on in the peninsula and in Woolwich. And there we can, in Plumstead, there's basically been not too much in the last few years. I know there's some regeneration coming in soon, but we can tap into the development, the SIL money that we get from the Greenwich developments, from the Woolwich developments. And we can invest more in Plumstead than we get. We don't need to have just 100%, we can have more than 100% invested in Plumstead. Because the High Street has been in and out since I've been here 5 years, is neglected. It's a neglected High Street. There's been poor planning, there's not, the leisure centre, why is the leisure centre there? Why can't it be closer to the centre? There needs to be a lot more, a greater approach to and focus on Plumstead and what the High Street, particularly Lakedale Road, and that environment needs. If we improve it, we'll get better, well, the environment better, and we'll have better shops and better place to live. So I came here 5 years ago, and we're on the edge of one of the world's great cities. We're going to be very well linked to it with Crossrail. We're going to be even more linked. We've got High Street, and we've got great green space at the top. And it's about time Greenwich County got behind this area, realised the potential, publicised it, worked with the South Eastern Rail to make a show of the place. And we can, going forward, we can make it this a better place.
I'm going to speak on behalf of the Labour Party. The motto of the council is we govern by serving. Matt and I and Reginda take that very seriously. We do have humility. We don't think we have all the answers. We're not experts. We're not people who stand here preaching to others. We're not saints. We're just ordinary councillors who work hard, who absolutely believe in this area. And guess what? We're very positive about Plumstead. We love Plumstead. And going on to the things that were being said there about Section 106 agreements, about minutiae of the way that things are added up and so on, we understand those things, of course we do. We're experienced councillors. To quote Gordon Brown, this is a time not for apprentices, maybe. This is a time for people who are serious. This is a time for people who are serious. This is time for people who know this area, and time for people who know how to invest in this area. Let's go back to what some people said there about investment. We are investing £40 million in the library. We are investing, with the Mayor of London, £5 million in the High Street. We are investing other money in other projects in the borough. We haven't closed across the borough a single library. We haven't closed a single children's centre. In fact, we have invested £11 million in our children's centre. That is a record to be proud of, and we are proud of it. And just to go to the final point, we want that, of course, we, with our ward budgets, we have spent money on different projects, and we've been very proud, including the Christmas lights, because it's not all about counting everything, it's about bringing a sense of pride and happiness to the area, and that's what we've been trying to do. So I want to end on a positive note, not a negative one, to say that I hope that you'll vote for us, and I hope that you'll give us the opportunity to continue with our stakeholder meetings where we consult people and continue to represent this wonderful part of our borough. Thank you.